Are you surprised that this merger went through?
Well, I was a little surprised about the way the judge made the decision. I think I said before the break, I was sort of 50-50, and so was almost everybody else in not knowing what the final decision would be. But when you read the judge's decision, it's a sort of personal view of what he thinks should happen. But I think that speaks to why it was so hard to predict. It's just really hard to decide what or figure out what one person is going to decide in a case like this.
And I was reading through your note, and you argue, frankly, that Sprint needed this more than T-Mobile. What does this mean for Sprint?
Yeah, no question about it. T-Mobile was going to be fine either way. It's good news for T-Mobile, but they were going to be fine either way. But for Sprint, this was really a make-or-break decision. They would have been in very dire straits without it. So clearly good news for Sprint, and therefore, by extension, great news for their corporate parent, SoftBank, as well.
Before we get to SoftBank, what does this mean for the new T-Mobile? What does the new T-Mobile now look like to you?
Well, you know, T-Mobile is in a really interesting position. Remember, T-Mobile on its own has been growing very, very rapidly in a very slow-growth wireless market by taking share. And this gives them an even better story to tell. Sprint obviously brings a lot of cost synergies. That's nice to have for margins and that sort of thing. But it also brings a lot of spectrum and network assets that, when combined with T-Mobile, gives T-Mobile what will arguably be a real network advantage versus AT&T and Verizon. For the first time that either of those companies have ever faced a company that has had a better network than they do.
Craig, you mentioned Sprint's parent company, one of the parent companies, SoftBank. SoftBank really needed this as a win as well, right?
It sure did. They've had their share of tough breaks, shall we say, with WeWork and Uber and BrandWorks, and they've just taken one blow after another. And so it's obviously been a rocky time for SoftBank. And had they lost this as well, it would have been a big problem. This is still a big piece of their equity value. They would have potentially had to take it in and take Sprint's debt onto their balance sheet. All those problems are now washed away. So a huge win for Masayoshi and SoftBank.
Craig, I have to bring it back to the consumer. What happens to my phone bill? Are my prices going up?
Well, I suspect probably not. But look, there's a reason why antitrust analysis and HHI says 4-3 is usually not good for prices. This case may be different. T-Mobile has some commitments under the consent decree to keep prices down, and they will clearly try to take share. But I think what the judge decided, interestingly, although the judge did spend a lot of time sort of deciding that he could read the motives and intentions of the various players with great acumen, but what the judge decided was that price isn't really the only thing that matters in this market, that consumer welfare is also a function of the quality of the networks, and that this would give a boost to Sprint T-Mobile in the sense of having a much stronger network that would almost necessarily force Verizon and AT&T to invest aggressively in their networks, and that's good for consumer welfare.